SpaceX is preparing for Flight 11 at full speed, as it looks poised to maintain its lead over its competitors going forward, especially with its latest mission secured through a Pentagon agreement. The question is whether Starship will soon contribute to this initiative. Let's discuss all of this in today's episode of NR Studio. We're getting closer to the Flight 11 date, with preparations actively underway at the launch site and for the spacecraft itself. The launch pad is undergoing upgrades as SpaceX implements new technology following the removal of outdated test equipment. B-16 remains in the rocket park, awaiting its transfer to the launch area, while spacecraft 38 appears to have completed the necessary evaluations and is now awaiting the installation of a dummy payload and flight termination system. Things are slowly starting to improve for what could be another pivotal and emotional moment for SpaceX. Above all, the primary focus is ensuring the success of the upcoming flight. A successful mission is crucial to maintaining SpaceX's momentum, especially with its recent substantial Pentagon contract win. SpaceX has once again solidified its supremacy, leaving competitors like ULA and Blue Origin far behind. As reported, SpaceX, ULA, and Blue Origin have all been selected by the Pentagon and the U.S. Space Force for National Security Space Launch Phase 3 Track 2 contracts. These arrangements involve large-scale, complex missions that demand the highest accuracy and reliability. Of the total missions, SpaceX has been assigned 28, representing more than half the total. ULA will manage 19 missions, accounting for 35%, while Blue Origin has only received 7 missions, or about 10%. These contracts will be allocated annually, with specific missions assigned for each fiscal year. For fiscal year 2026, the allocations have been clearly outlined. SpaceX will execute 5 missions, ULA will be responsible for 2, while Blue Origin will receive no assignments for that year. It is important to note that these allocations do not imply immediate launch. Typically, missions are awarded several years in advance to allow for advanced funding and preparation. The current series of contracts covers missions projected from 2025 to 2029, with actual launches expected between 2027 and 2031. Prior to this announcement, the Space Force had assigned 1 mission for fiscal year 2025. This distribution reflects the status and readiness of each company's existing rocket fleet. SpaceX continues to lead in this area with its reliable Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy, both of which have been in service for several years and have demonstrated their reliability through consistent performance. ULA's Vulcan rocket recently achieved launch certification, a significant milestone despite several delays. In contrast, Blue Origin's New Glenn has only conducted 1 launch and has not yet been certified for regular operations. Space Systems Command has clearly stated that there are currently no missions allocated to the third provider, Blue Origin, which will have another mission opportunity in fiscal year 2027. This statistic speaks volumes about SpaceX's continued dominance in the launch sector. During fiscal year 2025 alone, SpaceX secured 7 missions worth $845.8 million, while ULA secured only 2 missions worth $427.6 million. This stark difference underscores the growing confidence the Pentagon and Space Force have in SpaceX's established capabilities. Moving forward, SpaceX's steady performance positions it to maintain a faster operational pace than its competitors. The sheer number of assigned missions allows SpaceX to efficiently manage its workload, ensuring its rockets, personnel, and infrastructure remain engaged. Meanwhile, ULA and Blue Origin risk accumulating delays if they fail to establish stable flight operations quickly. Regarding specific missions, the 5 tasks assigned to SpaceX for this deployment are particularly significant. They include the USSF 206 mission, which involves the deployment of Boeing's 12th wideband global SATCOM communications satellite, along with 3 classified Space Force payloads labeled USSF 105, 149, and 63. In addition to the NROL-88 reconnaissance mission for the National Reconnaissance Office. For these 5 missions, SpaceX is expected to earn $714 million. In contrast, ULA only received 2 missions, USSF-88, which is intended to deploy 4 GPS-3 follow-on satellites, and NROL-88, another reconnaissance mission. Together, these missions generated a total of $428 million, significantly less than SpaceX's revenue. However, the most notable difference goes beyond the number of launches. Cost efficiency is also a determining factor. SpaceX continues to lead in this regard, with each launch costing between $120 million and $140 million. By comparison, ULA's Vulcan rocket costs approximately $214 million per mission, and the reasons behind this difference are clear. Reusability plays a crucial role. SpaceX's Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy booster rockets are typically recoverable and reusable, significantly reducing costs and speeding up turnaround times. In contrast, ULA's Vulcan remains completely expendable, a model that increasingly seems outdated in today's era of reusable rocketry. All of these elements continue to underscore SpaceX's stable and superior position in one of the most competitive sectors of the aerospace market. Its proven track record, technological advancements, and cost-effective operations have once again made it the Pentagon's top choice for significant national security endeavors. Let's continue to show our support by commenting "Keep going SpaceX" in the comments section, liking the video, and subscribing to our channel for the latest updates on SpaceX's incredible journey. With SpaceX holding a dominant position in the industry, its rocket fleet continues to demonstrate impressive progress and durability. The Falcon series currently serves as the foundation of the company's launch operations, playing a key role in SpaceX's recent Pentagon contract. Interestingly, while the Falcon 9 remains prominent for its consistent and reliable launches, the Falcon Heavy has been noticeably less active this year. This decline in activity has fueled growing speculation that SpaceX might soon retire it, especially as Starship is still in its development phase. However, new information suggests an alternative scenario. According to Lieutenant Colonel Christina Stewart, who oversees materials for the Space Systems Command's NSSL Integration Division, the majority of missions scheduled for fiscal year 2026 will actually rely on the Falcon Heavy. Of the five missions awarded to SpaceX, four are expected to use the Falcon Heavy, while the Falcon 9 will handle only one, USSF 149. This deployment emphasizes the Falcon Heavy's unique capabilities, as these missions typically involve highly classified payloads and require launches to high orbits where superior performance and reliability are critical. This is good news for the Falcon Heavy, effectively negating the notion of its imminent retirement. Instead, the rocket is poised to remain a vital component of SpaceX's future launch portfolio. And this is just the beginning. This latest Pentagon contract award marks only the second phase of the five-year NSSL Phase 3 Track 2 agreement, implying there will be more opportunities for the Falcon Heavy to demonstrate its value and secure further missions in the years to come. While the Falcon rocket continues to be an integral part of SpaceX's operations, Starship is gradually emerging as a potential competitor in the same space. After numerous setbacks, SpaceX finally made significant progress with the success of Flight 10, marking a significant milestone in achieving full orbital capability. The next phase will target more ambitious goals, such as achieving a stable orbit, demonstrating two-stage recovery, launching operational payloads, and establishing a propellant refueling system. All of these goals are targeted for completion within the next 12 months. While SpaceX remains focused on lunar and Mars missions for Starship, the vehicle's potential for military and government applications is increasingly evident. With a massive payload capacity of up to 100 tons for the V3 and potentially 200 tons for the upcoming V4, Starship could easily surpass any existing rocket in both size and reusability. Its economical and high-capacity launch capabilities will be of great interest to national defense and intelligence operations, particularly for deploying large satellite constellations or conducting deep space reconnaissance missions. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next time.